Hello friends, Satyendra here, and in this video, let's increase the part file accuracy in Creo Parametric. So let's get started. So first, let's understand the importance. So here I have a sheet metal part, which accuracy is very high. So when you design a part with higher accuracy, your feature doesn't fail, and getting a flat pattern is very easy. But if the default part accuracy is low, your feature start failing, and getting the flat pattern is very difficult. And to understand it, let's decrease this file accuracy. And for that, you go to the file, prepare, model properties, and here you have the accuracy. Change it. Now here you get two types of accuracy, relative accuracy and absolute accuracy. I will change it to relative, and I will decrease this value. I'll make it 0.01. And say regenerate. Now you see, the feature started failing. And if you see this circular cutout, this looks like an octagon. These cutouts are also not smooth. Not only this, you can see this surface. This is also not smooth. So when your default accuracy is low, you face this kind of problem. And the simple solution is increase the file accuracy. And for that, go to change and increase the file accuracy. So let's make it 0.0001, regenerate. You see, everything you got back. So this is how you decrease or increase the file accuracy. Now the next thing is, when you go inside this, you have these two types of accuracy. Then which one is preferable and what is the difference between these two? So the relative accuracy is relative to the size of this part. That means as the part size increase or decrease, the accuracy automatically changes, which is sometimes it is risky because some feature you may get without any error, but later on you may face some kind of error. And the absolute accuracy is the accuracy which is fixed all the time. So it doesn't change as per your part size. But the problem is when you have the absolute accuracy, your file size will be high, and it will take more time to regenerate the part. When you have the relative accuracy, file size will be less, and it will take less time to regenerate. So both are having their own advantages and disadvantages. But for the sheet metal part, I specifically maintain the absolute accuracy. And here also, you try to increase the file accuracy. So I'll just type 0.00001, and I'll say regenerate. Now it is showing the range. So you have this range, so your value should be in between this. So here you have the starting range, 0.0026. That means if you take this value as 0.0003, it will accept. Now say regenerate and say close. So this is how we increase or decrease the file accuracy in Creo Parametric. Now sometime when you go for new file, and you go to file, prepare, model properties, change, you don't get absolute or relative option here, because this file is directly taking the relative accuracy, and that is why you are getting this message. Specify relative accuracy by value. That means it is not allowing you to change to absolute. So in this case, you simply close this, go to file, options, configuration editor, find, and here you just type accuracy and go for find now. Now if you see carefully, you have this option, enable absolute accuracy. This is no, and that is why you are not getting that option. You simply make it yes, add change, close, and say okay. I'll just say no. If you say no, then this setting will be only for this file. If you say yes, then this will be saved in your config.pro. So every time you will get this option. So for time being, I'm just saying no, because this setting I just want for this file. Now if I go to file, prepare, model properties, change, I have this option, relative and absolute. So this is how you can activate this option if you are not getting. So here onwards, you make sure that when you design a sheet metal part, you have a higher accuracy so that your feature doesn't fail and you get your flat pattern easily. So that's it from this video, and I hope this video will be helpful. Now you can like this video if you find this video helpful, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.